In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to make use of the Amazon Echo Skills Kit Sound Library in Home Assistant. Check it out. What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. Before we get started, I should probably just quickly explain what the Echo Skill Kit Sound Library is, just in case you didn't know. And if you hear me saying the word echo a lot throughout this video, it's just to save me saying the other word, which may be a trigger and set off a lot of your guys' Amazon Echoes. So the Skills Kit Sound Library is a collection of different sounds that you can use within your Amazon Skills. Now, for our purposes, we're going to be using these sounds within our Home Assistant automations, and there's a whole bunch of different ones that you can make use of. I'll have this page linked in the description below, but on this page you can just browse through the various different sound effects, and you can also search for them. One other handy thing that you can do is actually play the sound in the browser, so if you find a particular sound that you want, you can just select it, and then you can just click play. If you're a subscriber of the channel, then you will have seen in the past I've done various different videos using the Amazon Echo and Home Assistant. We've done things like the text-to-speech, we've done actionable notifications, we've also had a look at custom MP3s. Now, if you are interested in any of those and you haven't seen them, you'll find links to them all in the description below. The purposes of all of these videos have been to get the echoes to give you a set spoken response or to play a specific sound or sound effect based on something that happens within Home Assistant. And the responses and feedback can literally be anything. In my examples, we had Shrek whispering to us, we had GLaDOS saying spoken phrases to us, and I also showed you how to create a little box that you could add to your dashboard, and whatever you type in that box, the Echo will just say it out loud.
Don't forget to subscribe.
And that all sounds pretty cool, right? To actually get started and begin making use of some of these features that I've just spoke about, you're going to need to have the Echo Media Player custom component set up and installed. Now, if you're not sure how to do that, in that very first video with the text-to-speech, I actually cover the full setup and installation of this, so go and check that out and then come back here. And if you've already got that set up and installed, then you'll be good to just carry on with this video. If you followed along with my tutorials or you read through the very well-documented custom component documentation, then you'll know that there's a section that allowed you to play sounds by making use of the media player.playMediaService. And as you can see here in the examples in the documentation, you can do things like service calls and script calls to actually select an individual echo and select the actual sound effect you want. And when you do this and make the call, it will just play that sound effect on the echo. And it just works really well. And if you don't like making use of YAML, it can actually all be set up through the UI. So again, you can just select the target, type your content ID, and just select that content type. The quality of the Amazon sound effects are really good, and the actual delay between clicking the call service or the automation triggering is very minimal. So you can now make use of those service calls and script calls, and you can apply those different sound effects wherever you want. There's a handy little known available sound section in that documentation, and if you just expand that, you can just view a list of all the known working sounds, and you basically just choose one of those and you use that ID, and then you place that in your service call or script. As an example, and one that's relevant to Halloween, there's a Halloween sound effect there, so if we wanted to make use of that, we just need to copy that ID. So the example here is called Horror 10, so we just simply copy that. And then back to wherever we're making that service call, we just need to swap the ID out. So for here, I've just got the simple service call from the example, and I'm just going to replace that for that horror sound ID. And we just put Horror 10 there, and then now when we click call service, we'll actually get that Halloween sound effect. And that's nice and straightforward and very simple to do, but one thing you'll notice is that this list of known sounds is very small. So for example, if you wanted more Halloween sounds, then you've pretty much only got that one to choose from. In the documentation, you'll notice that it says that additional potential sounds can be found here. And if we click that, that's going to take us to that Amazon page that I showed you right at the beginning, where you could pick the different sounds and test them out. On this page, we could just scroll through the list of available sounds until we find one that we want, or we could do a search for a particular type of sound effect we want. So if we're sticking to that Halloween theme, we could search for Halloween based ones, or if we wanted to, we could just stick to that whole horror theme. So if we did a search for horror, that'll bring up all the different horror sound effects. Now the one that we previously used was Horror 10, and that does appear in this list. Now if that appears in the list, why couldn't we just use Horror 11 or Horror 12? Chances are you probably tried this out yourself, so you tried changing the ID from 10 to 11 or 11 to 12, and then hitting that call service button, and you will have just noticed that you got no sound effect whatsoever. In order to actually get this to work and to be able to choose one of those sounds from the list and actually get it to play, we're going to need to swap out the service. So we're actually going to change from that MediaPlayer.playMediaService, and we're actually going to use one of the Notify services. Now, if you did the text-to-speech video and followed along with that, it'll actually be the same service that you used for that. Any of the code that I make use of in this video will be down in the description below, so feel free to look at that for reference, but you will need to update the parts to match your own configuration. So to get started with this, we're just going to start with a blank service, and we're going to want to choose the notify service. So if you select service there and start typing notify, You should see that list start to populate with all of the different Notify services that you have. Now, if you have a lot of Echoes, you should see them all here. So I'm just going to choose one of my Echoes from the list here, and I'm going to go for this downstairs Echo. So I can see this notification, send a notification via the Echo Media downstairs Echo. So I'm going to select that one. And in the description there, you can see that it's going to send a notification message to that downstairs Echo. We then need to provide a message for the notification. So anything you type in this line will be what the Echo says. But rather than actually typing something in, we're going to want to use a sound effect. So if we head back over to the sound library, we can then choose one of these sounds. And again, you can just open them up and actually play them. Let's say, for example, we want this Horror 8. We could select that and then we could play it to make sure it's one that we want. And you'll see this little source code option here. So you can click this handy copy to clipboard button and then jump back over to your Home Assistant. Back in Home Assistant on that message line, we're just going to paste in that URL that we just copied. The final bit of information that we need to provide is just the data. So if you just tick that little box next to data, and then on the line for data, you're going to type and then colon and then TTS. If you then go ahead and click that call service button, you'll hopefully hear whichever sound effect you chose to use. And essentially all this is doing is it's just making use of a text-to-speech notification, but rather than actually providing it with some text to say, we're giving it the audio source URL, and then that just looks up in the sound library, the sound effect to use, and then it plays it. And you can use that method to make use of any of these different sound effects. And again, sticking with that Halloween theme, if we wanted to use a different Halloween theme, we could do a search for something like ghost, and we could find a ghost sound effect. So let's just randomly choose one of these. So we'll go for spooky sound 4. And then again, we just copy that to the clipboard. And then back over in Home Assistant, we just update that message body and then just simply press call service and we'll have that new spooky sound. And that's literally it. Following along with this method is going to allow you to make use of any of those sound effects within Home Assistant. And if you wanted to take what we've just learned and turn it into an automation, then you can do that. If you just start up a new automation and then just set a trigger. So in my example here, I'm making use of a door contact sensor. So when this door sensor opens, I'm just going to add an action. If you still happen to have the developer tools open, you can just copy the code straight from that by just heading into YAML mode and selecting it all. If you then head back into your automation and again swap that to YAML mode, you can just paste that in and then revert it back to the UI editor. So with this example, when that door sensor opened, it would have played a spooky sound and that would have been perfect for Halloween, but maybe you can make use of this next Halloween or with something else around your house or even an upcoming holiday like Christmas, but probably not using spooky sounds. And that's just about it for today's video. If you have enjoyed it and found it useful, then don't forget to drop me a like. And if you're not already, hit that subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. And as always, a massive thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my Patreons. If you're interested in helping support my channel and becoming one of these awesome dudes, there'll be a link to my Patreon in the description below. But thank you for watching and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.